Freezing rate, it will be based on the freezing rate, mean the rate of the movement of the ice front. Then we can classify freezer equipment into slow freezers, quick freezer, rapid freezer, and ultra rapid freezer. This is food, for example, when we do freezing, liquid water from the surface will become ice first, and then this will become ice, enter into the center. And how fast the movement of this ice front can be also used to classify into different groups of freezer. Now we're going to discuss different typical freezers which are available, which are used nowadays. The first one is plate freezers. Plate, okay? This one has another name. It's called contact freezer or block freezer. Okay, this one has other two names. Contacts, because you need the contact between the plate, the cold plate, and your food. Block means when you do freezing, you have block of products, something like that. Okay, so you see there are plates of metal. This is metal. And then the cryogen is circulated inside this plate. This cryogen is at the evaporation state, so it's very cold, it takes the heat. So it makes the surface of the plate very cold. And then we put the food in between the plate, and then we compress the plate. Okay. For example, before you load the food, the plate are like these from each other. You put the food and you close them near, you bring them near together. And so they will compress a kind of good contact with the food between the plate. Okay, like that. And so what do you need in this system? You need the food to have the same size, to have the same shape, should have a good contact surface. This, you need the food to have good contact surface with the plate, so the plate can take the heat from the food and freeze the food. So the advantage of this system is you have fast freezing, because good contact, the contact between metal and food, good contact, good heat transfer coefficient. So you have fast freezing rate. But the disadvantage is that this one is quite specific, means that it's not really flexible. You cannot use it to freeze the legs of pig, for example. No. Because this one do not have good contact surface. How do we freeze shrimp with this system? You cannot freeze individually shrimp one by one, but you can do this. We have a cup, like a container, like a tray, and then you put shrimp inside, and then you pour water. So you make full of water, and shrimp is under the water, and you put here, you freeze, and then you have block of maybe 10 shrimp together, one block. Then you can do that. You should make it have a good, like, flat surface. But then you carry, when you sell this, you carry a lot of water along the way. It's also expensive. And this was applied long time ago, but nowadays people don't buy shrimp anymore because it's costly to carry, to transport. Now they do freezing shrimp. Mostly they use cryogenic freezer with liquid nitrogen to have individually frozen pieces. Okay, we have another system. This is very common, air blast freezer. The freezer which you cold air blast means blowing, fast blowing of cold air. This is a circulation fan, the fan that circulate the air. This air is brought into heat exchange with the evaporation or the evaporator of mechanical refrigerator. So the temperature of the air is going down and the air is moved out and then blow through a trail of food. Here you put food. This cold air will take the heat from the food. The temperature of the air may go up a bit, and then it go to another evaporator to cool it down, to take the heat from the food and go to evaporator. Okay? The evaporator part of mechanical refrigerator we discussed in previous slide. Okay, the very prominent advantage of this system is very flexible. Flexible means you can apply for many types of food, for different size, for different shape. Today you apply this food, tomorrow you can apply with the other food. You can freeze many types of food. It's flexible. It's also quite fast freezing because you blow the air. The air ventilated very well, so you have quite good heat exchange. This system, you can freeze a leg of pig, or like a carcass of pig. What is the disadvantages is that you may have quite some waste loss. What is waste loss? Because of what? Evaporation of water from the food, or sublimation of water from the food, of ice from the food. Because the air moves so fast, so it stimulates the evaporation of water from the food. To limit this, you should increase or reduce relative humidity of the air. When you increase the relative humidity of the air, then you can reduce the weight loss. But when you do that, you have quite a lot of frost, you know, frost. Because the vapor in the air will condensate on the evaporator, on the cold part, right? And then it become ice here. Right, so this one is used very commonly because very flexible. In also this group, we have belt freezer. It's also used in air, blowing air. But this is a continuous system that food is transported in one end and then out the other end. And then the air is moved like this. It's going down here, release the heat to the evaporator of mechanical refrigerator, for example, and then it go up, it take the heat from the food, and it is cooled out again. So the air is moved like this, one down, okay? This is belt freezer. This is more specific in application, but it's for large-scale processing because you do continuous freezing. This is more unit design. It's called fluid dye bed freezer. Similar like the bell freezer, the difference is that the blow of air is strong enough and the food should be small enough. Okay? So when the air moves like this, it will push up the food and the food will jump. The food will jump and will move like boiling water, like boiling liquid. Okay? It looks like liquid boiling. And that's why it's called fluid dye. Fluid means liquid. So the food is solid, but you make it behave like fluid. So the term is fluid dye. You make it bed. Bed means just like this is a bed. Okay? And then for some design, so this bed is kind of designed in a way that it will vibrate. It jump the food, the air, and also the vibration of the bed will move the solid food like a fluid. And the food will jump from this side to the other side. That kind of moving, what is the benefit? The benefits of that is the whole surface of food is available for heat exchange. Or when the food doesn't jump, or when the food move without jumping, then a certain part of surface is not available for heat exchange. But here, because the food jump up, and then the whole surface is in good exchange with the air, right? It's a good surface. So this system, you have very fast freezing. It's also individual freezing. Individual means one piece by piece. Okay. What are the disadvantages? It is flexible or not flexible? Not flexible. You need the food of the same size, the same shape, Small or large? Small. Small pieces of same size and shapes. You freeze the food in several minutes. It's very fast. And what is the other disadvantages? You may have quite amount of weight loss because of evaporation or sublimation, because air is blowing very fast. This system is suitable to freeze what? It is suitable to freeze carrot? No, but carrot dies. Carrot cube, small cube of carrot. Suitable for freezing ham? No. Ham dies means the ham that you dies in very small pieces. And like green bean, like corn. Okay. So this table will help us to compare different freezing equipment that we discussed so far. Air plus freezer. The application is universal, means it's very flexible for many types of food. Advantage, disadvantage, you may have dehydration, meaning weight loss. You lose water. Fluid dye bed freezer. This is another term, fluidization of fluid dye bed freezer. In Vietnamese, we translate this into Vietnamese what? Lạnh đông tăng sôi. Okay. Application is specific. Small pieces of food, same size, same shapes that we already said. Disadvantages and advantages. This is advantages. You have individual freezing. You have fast freezing. But the disadvantages is you may have dehydration effect, weight loss. Contact freezer. What is the other name of contact freezer? Plate freezer. Block freezer. The application is limited because you need the food to have good what? Contact surface to the plate. The food normally should be in rectangular shape, in a cube of rectangular shape. The advantage is you have high freezing rate because good heat transfer between metal and food. But it's difficult to scale up. The system cannot be designed very big. Small size. This one we didn't discuss, so we can skip here. Cryogenic freezer application in universal. This is very popular in Vietnam now. We freeze fish, we freeze shrimp. The advantages, you have what? High freezing rate. You also can do IQF. What is IQF again? Individually or individual quick freezing. Now there's another type that we didn't discuss, is immersion freezer. Immersion freezer is like, you make a liquid. This liquid should have low temperature, for example, -10°C. And then you transport your food, you submerge your food under the liquid, it gets frozen, and you have the product. What is the advantage of this method is you have good contact between cooling medium and the food, so it's freezing fast as well. But what is the disadvantages? That this liquid will contaminate the food. The liquid here will stick to your food, right? What is the freezing point? For example, can you use water to freeze the food in this way? Can you use water to make at -10°C? What is the freezing point of water? 0°C. If you low like this, it's already ice. How can you dip your product? So in order to lower the temperature like this with water, you have to add quite amount of salt, for example. Or you add glycerol, for example, to lower the freezing point. If you add salt, you freeze your shrimp, and then your shrimp also gets some salt. Or you freeze the meat, your meat becomes salty. Application is limited. Okay, here you have the contact with the cooling medium. This is disadvantage. Now, in Vietnam, this method is applied can you give an example in Vietnam, where do we apply this? You can see this many places in this district even. What do? In restaurant to make bia tiết, you know bia tiết, icing beer. So you can buy this kind of freezer. Here they set for you -10, -5. And you put your bottle of beer, and then some ice are formed in your beer. The temperature should not be very low, otherwise all become ice. maybe minus 5, minus 7. And then some ice form in your beer and you drink this beer, it's quite okay. Bữa nào đi nhà hàng bia tiết á, nhìn cái thiết bị của họ nha. Đây là kiểu lạnh đông dạng nhúng. Mà làm bia nó có một cái lợi là bia nó có cái chai. Cho nên trên cái chai nó dính muối có vấn đề đâu, không sao hết. Nhưng mà làm thịt á, thì cuối cùng nó